What's up guys, hope you're doing well. After installing Substance to Maya with the installer supplied, in Maya UI, you will find a new shelf tab named Substance to Maya. Open it by clicking on the icon. The interface is composed of one main button for create automatically the entire node tree of the shader based on the different options below, a message log field for information or errors, the texture files, extension switches to easily choose what best suits your workflow, extra channels that include emissive, opacity, and displacement, and last but not least, the advanced options to control advanced features. UDIM workflow. If you're working with UDIMs, ASIS OSIO workflow. If you're working with ASIS OSIO config file from ASIS Central, and an option for advanced shading control on your maps. Keep in mind that these options are additive. Also, you've got a secondary section about S2M, including this video overview, the contact mail for technical or licensing support, and my social links. Okay guys, let's see Substance to Maya in action and how to use it. I've just opened this scene that contained these oil barrels as a unique prop. The prop contains 4 shaders and their relative UVs. Normally you will need to create manually the shader tree for each shader with at least channels like albedo, roughness, metalness, normal. Load the files, take off some particular settings, color space, etc. and do it multiple times. What a pain in the butt. With Substance to Maya, you just need one click. Everything is configured and ready to go. With S2M, you will focus on the important thing and not the boring and repetitive ones. So let's make this prop ready by creating the 4 shader trees together. First, let's choose the texture files extension. I will go for EXR because it is always the best option for precision, depth and quality. But you are free to change it as you desire or current workflow. I don't need extra channels for this shader, but you can activate them easily if needed. For the advanced options, I need ASIS OSIO workflow because I'm using ASIS for this project. A quick side note here, we are in Maya 2018. And using the 2018-22 version of S2M plugin. So by default, it's set to work in sRGB, but you've got the option for the ASIS workflow with the OSIO config file from ASIS Central. If you work with ASIS, make sure that you've enabled color management and load the ASIS config in your preferences. At the contrary, in the 2022 version of S2M, by default it's set to work with Maya ASIS. But you have the possibility also to choose the option for OSIO ASIS. Okay, that said, let's also activate the advanced shading control option. Now click on the main button to create the full PBR shader. Input the texture set name that you use in Substance Painter and hit OK. Boom, done. You've got everything connected. File node already populated with the image path, the right input device transform, and also as requested, the advanced control nodes. Now just apply the shader to your geometry. Let's do it for the remaining 3 shaders. Done, in no time. Let's launch the IPR now to check that everything works. Really nice. Another thing, to make your life even more easier, I create 6 export presets for Substance Painter. Okay, so let me switch to Substance Painter to show you what I'm talking about. Here's the Substance project file with our prop. If you have installed the presets correctly by following the instructions, you will find under Export Textures, Windows panel, the S2M export presets. 6 export presets already configured with all the output maps. First category is for standard texture sets with the 3 texture files extension. The second category is for the UDIM workflow, again with the 3 texture files extension. So in settings, choose the desired preset, for example S2M EXR. File type, choose based on output template and select the desired size and hit export. When it's done, just remember to copy the textures to your source images folder in your Maya project. By the way, for the ones that are using Adobe Substance 3D Painter version, it's working exactly the same as in previous algorithmic version. Now let's open another project with UDIMS to get everything covered. Let's switch also to Maya 2022 for the sake of the demonstration. We've already exported our textures in Adobe Substance 3D Painter with the UDIM PNG preset. So select PNG, displacement, as we will be using it, UDIM workflow, and advanced shading control. Hit the main button, input the texture set name, and hit OK. Boom, done. You've got everything connected, file node already populated with the image path, and also as requested, the displacement and advanced control nodes. Now, just apply the shader to your geometry. Let's launch the IPR now to check that everything works fine. Really nice. That's all for the overview, folks. Thank you for your attention, and let's go create some exciting stuff.